have your attention, please? Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Alumni Weekend 2011 Celebration Dinner. And we have a lot to celebrate this evening. We've had a wonderful, wonderful day of presentations and walks around campus. We've had beautiful music, lots of fun interaction this weekend, and I hope that continues this evening. I'd like to, first of all, just say a couple words of thanks to our presenters, Dr. Lauren Logston, Dr. Junius Rodriguez, Dr. Tolliver. I'd like to thank the staff and Sodexo Catering and all the other folks who have made this possible, including our wonderful alumni board. It is now my pleasure to introduce to you my report, the person I report to, and my wonderful boss, Mike Murtaugh, the Vice President of Development and Alumni Relations.
She never calls me wonderful boss. She calls me a lot of other different names, but never wonderful. Thank you so much, Shelley. Thank you all for coming. Welcome to Eureka College. I am Mike Murtaugh. It's my duty and responsibility today to say welcome. Welcome home to you alums, and welcome to all of you guests. I also have the good fortune to recognize a few people tonight, and if you could just raise your hand or stand as I recognize you, it would be greatly appreciated because you are the difference makers. You are some of the difference makers here at Eureka College. First person I'd like to introduce is Mariana Jackson of the Board of Trustees, Ernie Potter, a former trustee, and the class of 64, five. Don Whittler, class of 60, former trustee Dick Johan from the class of 50, former trustee Sam Harry, from the class of 62, and trustee and the member of the class of 61, the Golden E class, and the president of that class, John Garrett. I also would like to introduce two former presidents of the former president of the alumni board, class of 87, Steve Kirk. And the present president of the alumni board, and more importantly, mom, with a member of the class of, I don't know what class, 97, but also with your son, Paul, or Peter?
Peter's,
which is a class of 2020 something. We also have with us tonight a former president of Eureka College, General Paul Lister. We have current professor and just wonderful human being, Dr. Lauren Loxton. We have Professor Emeriti, Dr. Richard Sanders. We have Doc Traister and Betty Traister with us tonight. Way back there. Absolutely just wonderful. I hope I haven't missed anyone, but if I have, just let me know and I'll come back up later and make sure you get ready. The resume of a college is its graduates. I'd just like you to think about that for a second. The resume of a college is its graduates. And for 156 years, as I mentioned yesterday at the Golden E dinner, this college, your college, has been blessed to have had as graduates women and men of character and integrity, good mothers, good fathers, people of faith, people who have made a difference in their communities, men and women of God, and men and women who have gone on to business careers, men and women who have been teachers, men and women who have done just about everything that you could possibly do since 1855. Eureka College has one resume bullet that is exceptional. One of only 22 colleges in the university has such a bullet. and that is that Eureka College is a school that graduated a future president of the United States. Now, that's pretty significant. 22 colleges, that's all, out of 4,213 colleges and universities in the United States. Only 22 has a bullet point. For those of you who were with Dr. Rodriguez this afternoon on that wonderful tour of the campus concerning another important historical fact of Eureka College, is that this week, the United States will be celebrating the 150th anniversary of the firing on Fort Sumter. And as you probably know, I hope you know, this school was founded by abolitionists, people who thought that slavery was an abomination of epic proportions, but they just didn't talk the talk about that. They also walked the walk. So as Dr. Rodriguez explained today, they came and around the elm tree that was just outside this building, and many of them enlisted in the Union Army and walked off, marched off to the Battle of Shiloh, and a couple, several, didn't come back. And many didn't come back the same way as they left. Truly a historic college. One of the first schools in the nation that was founded by, as a coeducational institution, women and men equally. And as a result of this abolitionist strain, they believed in equality of African Americans and whites. So we were one of the first schools to admit African Americans as equal students on campus. And as a result of that, the sole surviving member of Ronald Reagan's class is an African American woman from Houston, Texas, who in 1928 had to come from Houston, Texas to Eureka College in order to receive her college education. Think about that. She had to travel from Houston, Texas to right here in the middle of the cornfields in order to receive an education that she so rightly deserved. Your college is an exceptional college. Your college historically is second to none. But most importantly, it's the people that make it. A college is not brick and mortar. A college is flesh and blood. So this evening we are going to recognize one man, three women, who exemplify this resume, the best of this resume. People who have made a difference. Thank you so much. I think that's all I have to do right now. But enjoy your meal, enjoy the music, enjoy the camaraderie, and most of all, thank you so much for coming to Eureka College. Thank you for being Eureka College graduates. Thank you for making a difference.